Alrighty guys, now it is time for Sly's two missions. We just got done with Murray's mission over at the RC Club. We had to disguise ourselves as a moose and get some information out of the other guards. So I think we're going to head over here and do this bear cave bugging mission before we do laser redirection. I can't remember which one is longer of the two, but we'll just have to wait and see. Here it is right here. Walked right by it. Let's hop on up here.
The wild bears in the area have been tagged with radio tracking devices. If you could snag enough of them, we should be able to set up a receiver array around Jean Bisson's house.
I'm always up for bugging someone's home.
The first step is crawling into that bear cave and stealing the goods.
I'm on it.
Alright, so now we've got to go deal with some more bears. We actually deal with bears more than we did in episode 6. So, here they are, they're snoozing.
Radio transmitters have all been tagged in their mouths. You'll have to sneak up and pickpocket it while they're yawning.
Sounds safe.
Stay clear of the thin, crackly ice. Walking on it is sure to wake the bears.
I'll keep that in mind.
Yeah, that would probably be a good thing to keep in mind. Alright, oh, missed that first one. I think it does take quite a while for them to yawn. So you have to just stand here awkwardly and wait. But there's the first one, radio transmitter. If you hit the ice, you're basically dead, because there's, like, what, 6 bears in here? And they're all going to wake up at the same time if they hear the ice. So, yeah, I don't know if these guys are hibernating. I guess they are. I thought, from what I've heard and what I've learned, you can't really wake a bear while they're hibernating. Like, it takes a lot to wake these guys up. But, I don't know. I guess you can wake these guys up just by a small crack of the ice. What the heck? Alright, there we go. I was kind of stuck or something. I don't know what that was. Alright, Mr. Bear, open your mouth and let me take your little transmitter thingy. There we go. Open wide, I'm the dentist. I am Sly the dentist. The dentist raccoon. Alright, gotta watch out for these small patches right here. Thank you very much. So I guess after we get all the transmitters, we're gonna have to go around the area, around the map, and place them. Oh, this is gonna be hard. I guess I don't have to climb up that. I don't know what the point of that little pole thing is, but because it wasn't necessary to get onto this ice. I guess the last bear is down here. Here he is. Alright, Mr. Bear, open your mouth. Any day now? There you go. So yeah, you kind of have to go around in a circle because there's only one way you can go. Yeah, that last part right there is kind of tricky. You can fail the mission even after you get all of the radio transmitters. On that last part where you have to swing on the hook, every now and then I'll miss it, and yeah, it's not fun.
To form a receiver array, you'll have to place the radio transmitters in precise locations around Jean Bisson's base of operations.
Seems easy enough.
Once you're in position, hit the circle button to place the transmitter.
Alright, so now we have to go place the 6 transmitters in precise locations, as Bentley said. So that we will do. That we shall do. The first one is right here, so we have to get up on top of this building and hop over there. Avoiding the guards along the way, of course. And there we go. It's funny, it's just a humongous tooth. That's what I don't get. Did we take the bear's teeth out? Like, were the transmitters on their teeth? Did we just pull the bear's teeth out and they didn't even care or, like, notice? That makes no sense to me. Alright, let's stick a tooth on the tree. And now we can hear in on his intercom.
Declared 128 in the forest. None bad considering they had to kill all them bears.
He's like talking about how many trees each group of his guards has cut down. I guess they're having like a contest or something. Oh, he's talking about how many acres they've cut down, not trees. That's a lot of trees, though. I guess the next one goes right here. Alright, so three more left. We're halfway done, and one of them actually goes on John Besson's house. So we're kind of working our way around in a circle. And yeah. Sorry if my voice sounds a little crackly. I don't know what it is. It's just some days it's perfectly clear, and some days it's still fine. Like it's not sore or anything, but you know, you have to clear your throat a lot. Do you guys ever get those days? Today is one of those days for me. Alright, so the last one will go on his house. And we'll be done with the mission. We can head over to laser redirection. Let's throw this guy off the edge. See you later, give me your coins, fool. Alright, we have to figure out... Oh man, to get up there we have to go back over here. Whoa, okay. I thought you could jump on that, but I guess you can't. I guess you can't get on the little... I can't... Like, can you not jump on things with Sly after you've used your paraglide? I guess not, because I was trying to land on these spikes and it wouldn't let me. It's pretty weird. Alright, let's see what this guy's got. I saw his pocket was shining. Just some topaz. There we go with the throat clear. Man, I don't know what's going on. I do have some water, though, so if need be, I can drink that during the recording. Man, my voice. There we go. I don't want to have to, you know, start clearing it every, like, 20 seconds. That'd be awful. Alright, well, there's the last transmitter. You guys don't have to listen to me clearing my voice that much longer. I say that because in this next cutscene, I'm about to drink some water. Alright, so let's go over here to laser redirection. Hop on inside and see what we've got to do.
To get to it. Wait for more global warming?
That industrial laser is used to cut through petrified logs. If it could be bounced out that window, with your help, I should be able to harness its energy to melt the ice wall and free the book.
How do I redirect that thing?
There should be a switch on the other side of this wall. Throw it and then head outside.
Alright, Bentley, we will do exactly that. We have to go through the, like a sort of like a puzzle thing along the way. Whoa, almost fell into the... I guess that's fire down there? Lava? Something. I don't know. Just a bunch of burning logs. Okay. I'm just gonna skip along this and keep going. Just keep jumping along. Okay, I guess... okay, I thought this was the same RC club, but it's just a different building. It looks the same. Does he have any loot? Yes, he does, but that spotlight will see me. The spotlight is moving pretty fast. Maybe I can, like, pick... His eyes are open. What the heck? Oh, yeah. Okay, that was a bad idea. Let's not try to focus on getting some loot. Let's just, you know, do the mission. That'd probably be the best idea. Yeah, that was... That's what always happens when I focus on loot. Like, outside of missions... It's fine, but if I try to, you know, get some loot or pickpocket anybody during a mission, it usually leads to me, getting killed. Okay, now where do I go here? Up this ladder? Oh, there's the vault, by the way. I almost missed that. Now that we have all 30 bottles, we can you know, use the vault.
Then the combination has got to be
583. And I wonder why they have the vault in this this random building. Usually it's like, you know, in an important place. Like, lightning spin, alright. Like, I was thinking it was going to be in John Bassan's house, but I don't think we ever go in there, so... They always put the vault, like, in a place that you can only, you know, go get it during a mission. I mean, sometimes they put it inside of, you know, like, they put it in Dimitri's office, they put it in Rajan's office. So, yeah, there were a few places that you could go if, like, if you missed it during the mission. But, here, go under the table. Stop trying. Sly was trying to pickpocket him. But most of the time, the vaults are during missions. I don't know if we can kill that guy or not, so I'm just gonna, you know, hide from him. Alright, well, we got the laser anyways, so we can head back out of here, and there is more to the mission to do. We've gotta redirect the lasers even more.
I see. I just walk to where the laser stops, place a crystal, and it'll bounce the beam to a new position. That log chopping book is as good as ours.
Alright, so I don't know how many, you know, laser redirections we have to do, but I have no idea how, they know, you know, like, how to do this. I mean, anything could happen here. Like, the laser could go any direction it wanted to. You could be out here all day setting these crystals down, trying to get it to point to the exact spot, and it probably wouldn't. I mean, maybe he looks at, like, the angle of the crystal or something like that. That's the only, you know, idea that I could have about that, because most of the time the laser is going to go whatever direction it wants to, unless you have an angle, a certain angle you're putting it at. But anyways, enough with my statements, my conclusions of why the game does what it does. Okay, well, these, we don't even have to put crystals down. We can just jump on these claw-looking things, and I guess when they break, it makes the laser redirect itself. Alright, let's go over here and put one down. And all the way over there. Okay. This mission's got us running around all over the place. You know, I kind of like missions like that. It's pretty fun.